Welcome back to Psychology of the Unknown. If you're new to the channel and are into true crime and ghost stories, then you're in luck, because that's all we do here. So make sure you stab the subscribe button with an ice pick and hang the notification bell on a meat hook before skinning it alive. Also make sure and give us a like and leave a bloody comment below. Today, I'll be telling you about the top 10 serial killers in Illinois that have the highest body count.
Yeah, we don't want to do anything to scare your children. That's the last thing we want to do. We don't want to scare anybody.
That's Kenny 911. What is your emergency? Thank you. Caller, what's the address?
Coming in at number 10 is Johann Otto Hotch, better known as the Bluebeard Murderer. He poisoned 15 plus women with arsenic between 1890 and 1905. He was sentenced to death on June 23rd, 1905, and was executed by hanging on February 23rd, 1906. At number 9, we have Raymond Martinez Fernandez, better known as the Lonely Hearts Killer. He robbed and then murdered 5 to 17 plus women and at least one child via overdosing them with drugs, strangulation, shooting, and drowning from 1947 to 1949. He was executed by electrocution at Sing Sing Prison in New York on March 8, 1951. At number 8, John Eric Armstrong. He raped and murdered 5 to 18 female prostitutes via strangulation between 1992 and 1999. He was sentenced to life in prison in Michigan on April 3, 2001. At number 7, we have a four-man crew, Robin Geck, Edward Spreitzer, Thomas and Andrew Kokoralis, better known as the Chicago Ripper Crew. They once worked for John Wayne Gacy and raped, stabbed with knives and ice picks, mutilated, and cannibalized 18-plus women from May 23, 1981 to October 8, 1982. Geck was sentenced to 120 years in prison on February 17, 1984. Spreitzer was sentenced to death on March 20th, 1986, but was commuted to life in prison in 2003. Andrew was executed by lethal injection in Illinois on March 17th, 1999. Thomas was sentenced to 70 years in prison, but was released on March 29th, 2019, due to cooperating with authorities. At number 6, Ralph Raymond Andrew, who raped and murdered between 4 and 20 women via shooting and stabbing with a knife from 1971 to 1991. He was sentenced to life and died in prison on January 31st, 2006. Coming in at number 5, Bell Sorensen Gunnis, who murdered between 13 and 42 men and children from the 1880s to 1908. Most of her victims were her suitors and boyfriends, but she may have also killed both of her husbands and all of her children on different occasions by way of poisoning with strychnine and bludgeoning. She was never tracked down and her death has never been confirmed. At number 4 is Larry Eiler, better known as the Highway Murderer. He murdered between 19 and 23 gay men via stabbing with a knife between 1982 and 1984. He was sentenced to death on October 3rd, 1986, but died of AIDS in prison on March 6th, 1994. And number 3 is Herman Webster Mudgett, better known as H.H. Holmes. The span of his crimes took place from 1886 to 1894. He murdered 27 plus men, women, and children through various means. He was executed by hanging at Moyamensing Prison in Philadelphia on May 7, 1896. At number 2 is John Wayne Gacy, who raped and then murdered 33 young boys and men by way of strangulation from 1972 to 1978. He was executed by lethal injection in Illinois on May 10, 1994. And at number 1, Micah and Wiley Harp, who killed between 39 and 50 men, women, and children through various means. They are considered by many historians as America's first true serial killers. The time span of their crimes was the late 18th century. Micah was killed in Kentucky on August 24, 1799, while Wiley was sentenced to death and executed by hanging in Mississippi on February 8, 1804. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss a single video. Give us a like, leave a comment below, and please share the video with your family and friends. I've been Shannon, and this has been Psychology of the Unknown.